Hi everyone, it's Kim. Welcome back to my channel, and if you're new to my channel, welcome. So today I'm bringing you my weekly update and my weigh-in. And it's been a few days since you've seen me. I finished up with the Vlogmas and took a little break. So I'm back. We're going to get right back into it. And I've got a couple more fun cook with me's coming your way. So stay tuned for those. So my week of Christmas went possibly like yours did. Couple of celebrations, the hustle, the bustle, the extra last minute shopping, and more probably restaurant food than home cooked meals. However, like we have said before, that if you maintained or didn't gain like a ton during December, call that a win. If you were conscious of what you were doing and formulated a new plan because you gained a little more than you wanted, call that a win. This is not about beating yourself up. This is not about having all that negative self-talk, and remember that negative self-talk, and we're going to come back to that. So it's not about having all that negative self-talk going on in your head. Every day is a new opportunity to start over. Every meal is a way to make a different decision or a new decision. Beating yourself up, it's not going to get you anywhere. I mean, I've been there. You've probably been there. We've all been there. So taking the opportunity to just jump right in where you are works. It really does work. And we've talked about this before. It's a journey. This is totally a journey. So let's talk about that negative self-talk real quick before we get into the weigh-in. Have you seen the new commercials? The new commercials is where they have the negative self-talk is the one that kind of makes me chuckle. The lady walks in and she's got this big bag. And she asked the person behind the counter, is this where I return my negative self-talk? Can I return it? And I thought that that was great because we've all been there with that negative self-talk. We've all beat ourselves up for whatever reason, whether it's you didn't do this or you didn't do that. And I mean, you can just fill in the blank. And I think that if you gave back that negative self-talk and started talking to yourself positively, give yourself that positive reinforcement, give yourself credit for the things that you do, I think that that's really going to give you and me a different outlook on this journey. So again, if you haven't caught that commercial, I think you could maybe Google it, but it's a really good one. So this week on the scale, and I could have taken the option to not weigh in. I mean, I really could have. Okay, anyway, on Christmas Day, Christmas Eve, my mom's pipe burst in her house. Here in Michigan, it was super cold during Christmas weekend. So the day that I thought I was just going to kind of get eased back into it, went into a whole nother day of restaurant food. Thank goodness we found a place open. So my husband was able to fix her pipe and we got that done, but I didn't have a chance to do any downtime. And with not having the downtime, I feel like I wasn't as prepared to hit Monday running for the new week because my weigh-in was Wednesday. And you know, when you have a tough weekend, you know, full of obstacles, that if you hit the ground running on Monday, at least you can reverse some of the things that happened. So Wednesday, when I got to the scale, a couple of my, you know, I'd heard a couple ladies say that they did not weigh in. They just chose to do what's called a no weigh. And which is great, because if that's what keeps you going, do it. Take a no weigh, you know, a no weigh in weigh day, if that will help level set your mind to keep that negative self-talk out. So I chose to weigh in. I was up 1.2. That same 1.2 that I lost the week before. That same 1.2, or let's just call it the 2.4 pounds that I've been playing with. I am exactly 2.4 pounds away from my 10 pound loss right now. And I keep playing with that same 1.2 over and over again. Now, I've got a plan. I've already put that plan into place. I'm focused, and I'm planning to get rid of that 1.2, hopefully that 2.4 within the next couple of weeks. So I would like to say this week, because that's what I wanted to do. I want it to be gone by next Wednesday, but I'm not going to put that type of pressure on myself. And you know, when you start to put that pressure on yourself, you start to make mistakes. One of my biggest pitfalls is that I will choose to not eat all of my points. I will restrict it so much that my body thinks that I'm starving it, and it holds on to every calorie that I give it. So I'm not doing that. I am eating my points. I am tracking everything. I decided to start getting some exercise in, and we'll talk about all that when we talk about the goals that I plan to set, not resolutions, but the goals I plan to set for the new year. I think that if I can start to incorporate, and they're not all, you know, some of them are some self-care and self-love things. So they're not all like, I'm going to eat this, or I'm going to like exercise 5 hours a day. It's nothing that drastic. It's just some new habits that I would like to get into place. And there's some repeat habits that I'm carrying over from the previous 2 years that have been working. So we'll get into those later. But again, a 1.2 gain, I was not even fazed by it. I kind of chuckled about it when she told me. So no worries. We'll figure that out. So we're going to move into this next week with a positive attitude. I am meal planned for the week. I did a grocery pickup. I will put that at the end of today's video so you can see what my strategy is for my meals this week. I have a plan for New Year's Eve. We're just staying in, so stay tuned. I will, maybe I'll film what we're having for dinner on New Year's Eve, because that'll be really cool. And of course, New Year's Eve, snacky food, right? So I'm looking forward to having some really healthy snacks and some yummy snacks. I mean, I'm not going to deprive myself. I'm going to have some good snacks that day. So stay tuned. I think I will film that. So stay tuned. I'll try to film that New Year's Eve and post that for you on New Year's Day. So with that said, I'm going to wrap up. Stay with me, because again, I'll put that grocery haul here next and show you what my dinner plan is for the week. So hopefully that kind of gives you some ideas. All right. So with that said, I'm going to sign off. I'm going to say thanks for watching. Keep those comments coming. Thumbs up, subscribing, all that good jazz. And here's my grocery haul. Okay. So we're going to start off with the meat and veggies. I picked up I wanted a turkey breast, but they substituted this whole turkey for my turkey breast. So I have this. They substituted my ham. I wanted a different type of spiral ham, but this is the one that they gave me as a substitution, and I had already planned my meal, so I went ahead and took this one as well. I got a 40-ounce bag of chicken breast cutlets. I haven't used these before, so I'm excited to give these a try. They're a little thinner slice, so I think they'll cook up more evenly. I grabbed some ground beef. We're going to have nachos on New Year's Eve. So my husband likes to have ground beef, and I'll make myself up a package of 99% free, fat-free turkey. Some ground turkey that's 99% fat-free, I guess is how we're going to say it. So he'll have beef, I'll have turkey. Picked up a package of turkey breasts just because, you know, it's always nice to have that available for sandwiches. I picked up two different types of veggies this week. We have the Fiesta style and the Italian style. And I thought that I would use this as fillers for my bowls this week. I have some cherry tomatoes, one green pepper, and some romaine hearts. So I'll go ahead and chop this up for salads. So that is my meat. Hold on, I'll show you what's next. I went ahead and grabbed some bananas this week because I already have apples in the fridge. I grabbed some russet potatoes because I wanted to make some french fries in the air fryer this week.
picked up 2 things of fat-free cottage cheese. I like adding this to my eggs, and I might make a frittata this week. I'm not sure, but we'll see. Biscuits were on sale. I had some type of coupon for that, so I went ahead and grabbed those. Those are nice to have in the fridge in case you're throwing together a quick breakfast, and I think they're not bad. I mean, they're not great on points, but you know what? Those are the best. I also picked up some cheesecake pudding mix of chocolate fudge cheese. Anyway, vanilla, chocolate, and cheesecake pudding mixes. And I have those together because I like to add those to my smoothies and sometimes to my oatmeal. Some spaghetti sauce and some spaghetti in case one of the grandkids are over, and that seems to be a really easy meal when they're here. Some pop chips. Those are really good. If you haven't tried them, they're super good. Grab some hillbilly bread. This is one of the lower point breads that is not cardboard thin. This is really one of my top choices when I'm picking up low point bread. Grab some turkey stuffing mix to go with that turkey that I just showed you. And I picked up some milk chocolate baking chips. So my goal is to buy all the different Lily's baking chips, because you can add these to your oatmeal. You can add them to so many different things. And I think I have the dark chocolate. I definitely have this one, the dark chocolate. I might have the caramel. And I think the only one that I'm missing right now is the white chocolate. So I'll have to check. I either bought the white chocolate or the caramel last time. But again, I'm going to have these ready to go. And so that it's nice to have some type of lower point items to bulk up some of your recipes, or just to kind of change them up a little bit. So, you know, if you don't plan on using it, I mean, I don't even plan on making anything with it other than adding them just to like breakfast and maybe a dessert or something. So looking forward to having that. All right, so that is all I have for today. So I just wanted to show you quickly what I got at the store.